Using a computer isn't the easiest thing to do for 74-year-old Linda Darby.
I can do it here with under instructions. I mean, I can manage, but it's not my best form of communication.
She uses it at her volunteer job at this senior center, and she wonders if her skills will be good enough for another task, getting herself an appointment online for a COVID-19 vaccination.
Actually, I'm quite worried about it. If there's any glitch or roadblock or whatever, then it's very frustrating.
Whether online or by phone, many seniors here are going to need help to book a shot. That's why a team is being put together.
A lot of our members have memory loss and dementia issues, so of course they might require some assistance as well.
Hi, this is Rabbi Tendler from Beth Tikva. How are you today?
Faith groups are also gearing up to lend a hand. The rabbi at this synagogue says many of its members already have questions.
What does it really look like and how does it happen? And so if we can help guide people who need that guiding and be there and stand 2 meters apart but by their side in order to get them through that line and out the other side.
So Monday morning, our volunteer will be here at 7 o'clock.
Since the pandemic started, this Sikh temple has run a food bank and given out hundreds of boxed meals every day. Now that distribution system is being used to tell people about the way the temple can help them get a vaccine.
They can call us, or if they want to be here, we can book for them and we can give also a ride.
The temple president says he knows all too well the importance of protecting elders as quickly as possible.
I want actually everybody protected, but our elders, they need first. Actually, I lost my mother in December, same with coronavirus.
All these groups hoping the work they're doing now will help prevent COVID-19 from taking any more valued members of their communities. Susanna De Silva, CBC News, Vancouver.